Well, hello there, my friends. Chris Marcus here with you for Arcadia Economics on a Tuesday morning, February 9th at noon Central. Welcome on in. A lot of silver events happening, so I'm going to try and keep this on the quicker side. We will have Nick Barashev coming on at 3 p.m. Eastern, 2 p.m. Central, so in 2 hours from now, who's done extensive research into SLV and can comment further on what he thinks is going on there. And probably a few more videos tonight, but I just wanted to let folks know that Joe Biden and Janet Yellen are having a meeting with others, including JP Morgan CEO Jamie Dimon. It is said here it's to discuss his $1.9 trillion stimulus plan. So perhaps good news. If you own silver, then no matter what they're talking about here, would certainly be good news of that. Although the agenda of the meeting was not available, White House said the group will review the critical need for Biden's rescue plan. Again, here you see it's amazing that Jamie Dimon is now in the White House. No note. There's some notes. Here we see Yellen, a former chair of the Federal Reserve, has stressed the importance of acting quickly to flush the U.S. economy. And I'm going to check if we are live. I'm getting an error message. Hopefully we are here. Hopefully you can see me out there. And I think we are live. So Yara, if you can send me a message, if this is coming through now, I'll keep going for now, but here you see Yellen, a former chair of the Federal Reserve, has stressed the importance of acting quickly to flush the U.S. economy with even more fiscal support, even after $900 billion was passed in December. I believe that could be coming soon. I'm not entirely sure, but keep in mind, this is all happening. Even this was all in place before there was a thing called silver squeeze. Here you see, I have not watched this video yet, but and it looks like I am live, which is good news. So I've not gone through the numbers here. I've heard about this from a couple folks that 40% of all of the dollars that are in existence were printed in the last 12 months. And now Janet Yellen, Joe Biden, and Jamie Dimon are having a meeting, presumably of how to print more and faster than that. Well, silver is sitting here up 13 cents on the day. Still about half of its 1980 $50 high, which given that 40% of all the dollars in existence were printed in the last 12 months, according to that headline, is one of the reasons why I would maintain what I've been saying, that silver is quite undervalued according to anything that we would experience in free market terms. And which brings us to the point, you know, you also see this divot here. And I know a lot of you have seen that Bart Chilton clip a lot of times, but you're going to get it again today because this sure matches what he defines as spoofing. In fact, you can see it here, how there's this big spike in volume and then the price once again falls off a cliff. And given all of the concerns that I raised the other night in this video, which is on my channel, what SLV investors should know about JP Morgan and send to the CFTC, SEC, and DOJ, I think I mentioned the White House in the video at some point, so maybe I'll just be optimistic. I'll imagine that's what they're discussing because I raised a series of questions here that are in the description field below. In fact, we can even take a look that if I were Joe Biden and I really believed in the things that have been said about bringing integrity that they all say, here are some dates that I would encourage the CFTC to pull trading records. By the way, I did make contact with the CFTC today, which we'll get to, and a bunch of other questions. Hopefully that's what they are discussing in this meeting in the White House, because I have yet, you know, some of the guests that I bring on my show, I've yet to find an investor, fund manager, or anyone who watched the evidence that was laid out there and has said something other than if they had SLV, they would sell it immediately. And I think people recognize me, or I don't know, maybe there is or isn't risk in saying something like that. That's the last thing I want to do, is go out and put myself at risk. Yet the things that are laid out in this video, I think I would be at greater risk if I came on and promised to give you honest information about what I think is going on in silver. I never claim that I'm getting every single thing right, but I show you why. I explain as best as possible. I would consider myself fraudulent if I knew about the things in that video and I didn't say anything. So that is on February 7th. You can find it on the main Arcadia page. Curious, in the meeting with Jamie Dimon and Joe Biden, are they discussing this headline that appeared 4:59 a.m. February 2nd, which was a week ago today, the day that in the face of what I have multiple dealers who put their face on camera, unlike J.P. Morgan, who settled multiple cases and has never commented, but the bullion dealers came on my show. They commented what they described panic buying in excess of the Hunt brothers. Came on there. They've done it on other shows. They put their name to it. Here's J.P. Morgan with a headline and a report that in the face of that, and in the face of something else they didn't mention in their report, claiming that 110 million ounces of silver were added to that SLV trust on the Friday before this February. This was a Tuesday. So the Friday and the Monday. And then on this day, you had 61 million ounces alone. To put in perspective, the 110 million ounces, I believe that's more physical than the Hunt brothers actually held. I know they had the futures contracts. I don't remember the exact breakdown now, but 110 million ounces, that's over 10% of the annual supply, of which 900 plus is already accounted for when you factor in the physical demand. So they just ate the rest in 3 days. They didn't mention that. And then you have what's pointed out here. Well, actually not there, but in this one, on in the middle of that, the price came down 10% in a day, in the middle of the three-day period where J.P. Morgan is reporting that they added 110 million ounces into the silver trust. Anyone who watches the show has seen, I have yet to find a guest or anyone who thinks that's possible. Although fortunately, Ronan Manley wrote an incredible article, which I can't recommend highly enough. Houston, we have a problem. 85% of the silver is already held. He goes through the calculations of, based on all the trusts that are out there, unless there's silver going to start appearing from somewhere else, I would bet on Ronan Manley as an expert witness in court. I would stake my reputation on it. And he goes through those calculations. Although what I thought was even more stunning is, along with what I've reported about the SLV audit facilities or lack thereof, which even the iShares representative couldn't find until I asked her to please check with anyone else who might know. She said, I think there might be something on the Edgar database for the SEC. Here we see that the other silver trust, if you think you haven't been stunned yet, wait till you see. Here's SSLV by Invesco and is claimed to be in JP Morgan's vault in London. Custodian is JP Morgan. Here, PMAG, PMPM, custodian is JP Morgan. Here, custodian of SIVR, GLTR. You can read through the thing. It doesn't get any better. And I've heard from Dave Kranzler that he was able to find some sort of audit in August. I'm tracking that down from him. If that exists, I will report it. I was just going off the information that the iShares, I couldn't find it on their site. And I called and spent 40 minutes on the phone, asked multiple times. They were only able to give me something that was stamped with some dates that I would say certainly as an investigator warrant further investigation. Again, as I will mention before we wrap up, I did contact the CFTC and we are in the process of organizing evidence and we will have clear instructions. And I would encourage people along with myself, submit the evidence to the CFTC. Finally was able to reach someone today. She was helpful and at least called me back. So I'd suggest for anyone who's said for the last 20 years, they're never going to do this or that. For now, forget it. Just flood their inboxes, submit the claim. Who knows? As I'll show, there is a whistleblower award, and hopefully that's I believe they say they've paid out $120 million, so hopefully people will get some reimbursement. I'm also would like to know perhaps someone in the Wall Street Silver Group, which is beyond incredible, and we will get to them before we wrap up. Maybe they can find out where that money has gone to. But again, just in case you want to send this video, maybe this isn't the best one, but just again as reference to explain what happens here, where you see this is the blue is the volume. And fortunately, which I think would be relevant to the CFTC, I had the fortune to interview Bart Chilton, who was one of the commissioners of the CFTC during one of their investigations into silver manipulation. I asked him, my understanding, this is the man who's able to see the records, was part of the investigation, and you can hear what he says here.
Again, I appreciate you mentioning the spoofing. Curious, because my understanding of how some of the manipulation has occurred is that, you know, if silver is trading $20.05, there's a lot of stop orders placed around the $20 handle. So often if the price can get pushed a little bit, then you get a lot of those high frequency algorithms kicking in, and then you'll see a drop, with many feeling that people kind of nudging a little are then able to buy lower. Does that sound like a reasonably accurate portrayal to put it in perspective to folks, or would you phrase it differently?
Well, it's a good portrayal, but it's a very good portrayal.
You can find this also on the YouTube channel. He talks about the specifics of spoofing, how now the only difference is that when it occurs, it's bigger. That's what you see here on this chart. That's also what the CFTC, and I'm told the legal term that JP Morgan settled with the CFTC, not technically fined. That's a distinction. I want to be as accurate as possible. But that was over spoofing. And this, I have yet to find any financial professional who can find another explanation than that this is exactly what Bart Chilton just described. So again, here is the CFTC's site. This is whistleblower.gov. Apply for an award. This is some nice little news here. We'll click on this for a second. If you Google CFTC whistleblower, somewhere it says that, oh, here we go. CFTC has awarded more than $120 million to whistleblowers since issuing its first award in 2014. Now, JP Morgan has already been fined, and in the research I've done, I think the precedent to actually have a chance to claim the award actually goes up exponentially when there has been a fine, so there is a specific case. I've been preparing my own whistleblower application. I like to think that I've helped some people out there. I thought that the one weakness, while I had contacted them before, while I did the interview with Bart, while I communicated with Bart in 2011, and the interview I did, with that was from 2019. It was about 2 years ago. The one weakness in my application was I had not submitted a tip, but certainly I'm going to be writing up clear instructions about why I think this fits the definition, and certainly the details of what happened last week, why I think that fits the definition too. And again, because I really encourage anybody to do that, I have someone on our team right now making as clear as day, so you could one click, press, send, regulators, congressmen. So we are going to help with that. Also have some encouraging news about the lawsuit against JP Morgan. Perhaps I'll hold off on that for today, but just can hit the subscribe button and notification bell if you'd like to stay posted with that. So anyway, if you wanted to submit something today, which, I mean, by all means, go ahead and submit. I know there's a lot of people on the Wall Street Silver and other groups that are compiling great evidence. Don't wait for me. Submit this, submit more. There's plenty of stuff to submit. You know, I watched The Big Short the other day, and I was struck by that scene where the Jared Bennett, I don't know if you remember that, or whatever the actor's name is, he mentions how these guys find it. They looked. How does Wall Street, they make you feel too stupid to ask the question? They hope you never look, but You don't even have to look because, hey, watch this one. Or go to Wall Street Silver, where these guys are doing, it's truly inspiring for anyone who had given up hope at any point in the last 20 years. Now we have people who are taking these links. There's 467. You just saw another person upvoting. They're taking the research. I'm putting things on Twitter. They're taking it. They're researching it. So especially for the older guys who have lived through the pain, if there's ever been a time to just say, hey, we have some energy. These guys are on the ropes. This is possible to expose and end this now. I would encourage you to let go of anything that's happened and join, because the best part about this is completely legal, moral, ethical, and honorable. I find it honorable because just by exposing the truth and what stuff that has been hidden, and these guys leave their fingerprints everywhere. Last note before we wrap up, I did see there was an interview with someone in the metals industry claiming that there was no case for manipulation. The price is not suppressed. And people have been saying that for years, and it's nonsense. And that's why it hasn't happened. Just to the degree, I know there's a lot of people who are new to this saga and could hear that. And again, I always encourage you to do your own research and see what makes sense to you. But to the degree, I think that, you know, sometimes people don't always know the history. I would say the assertion that it hasn't happened yet means that there's nothing behind it. Again, you can watch The Big Short or read about the people who talked about the housing bubble advance, many of whom are guests on my show now. And had they taken that approach, they would not have seen it in advance. And there are a lot of things that haven't happened yet, but sometimes they do. And of course, just because I would suggest, don't take my own opinion for it. Here's the proof that Deutsche Bank and UBS traders rigged the market. This came out in December of 2016, was not mentioned in that interview yesterday. Some of the smoking guns, this was widely reported. Plaintiffs are now able to plead with direct smoking gun evidence, including secret chats involving traders, submitting a number across a number of institutions, well-coordinated, wide-ranging. And I'm not even sure if that's actually the guy that got a settlement, but Deutsche Bank documents show, among other things, how two UBS traders communicated directly with two Deutsche Bank traders and discussed ways to rig the market. Occasions, the infamous previous metals slam, when out of nowhere, billions in notional contracts emerge, usually with the intent to sell, to halt any upside moment in the precious metals. This was 4 years ago. I would think that anyone covering the metals should have read this by now. And here we have, okay, this is, to be fair, this is what the plaintiffs allege, but let's see if there's anything to support this, where chat between Deutsche Bank and HSBC says, really want to sell silver, to which the other trader says, let's go and smash it together. I will repeat that. Some examples include a chat between Deutsche Bank and HSBC traders in which one trader says, I really want to sell silver, to which the other trader says, let's go and smash it together. So I would suggest anytime you hear somebody saying there's no evidence and that's conspiracy theory and the price is not suppressed to the downside, ask them what they think about the HSBC trader who said to the Deutsche Bank trader, I really want to sell silver, and what that same person thinks about how the response was, let's go and smash it together. I am not a lawyer, but I, at least from watching on TV, I believe when it's between independent organizations, and certainly here is more than two, that I think that's collusion. Someone can correct me here. Maybe anyone who does not, who thinks that's conspiracy theory, could ask why Deutsche Bank trader on a public chat, which I worked on a trading floor, you should know better that these things can get read and pulled, but still decided to say we're the silver market based on feedback from outside traders, to which UBS replies brilliantly on record, we smashed it good. Leading to the lament that his friends are jealous, fucking hell, UBS, now you make me regret not joining. So similar to that scene in The Big Short, they're not confessing, they're bragging. finally, for all the traders who wonder what happened to their stops, now you've heard me comment multiple times how, especially when you have margins raised, and these banks, keep in mind, when I was at Wharton and I was going to, I interviewed with these banks. Thank God I didn't get hired by one of them. But while everybody who applies knows you go there because you want to trade it up, make as much money as you can, they're supposed to be customer desks. The JP Morgan trader confessions to the Department of Justice confirm that they screw their customers. Here, you heard Bart Chilton confirm that they know what the chart guys are reading. They know where the customer stops are placed because they have a mandate to serve their customers, which has been violated here. And again, because sometimes there are people that are new that don't know the full history, and I want to make sure things get reported accurately, that for all the traders who wonder what happened to their stops as a result of the dramatic move in price, here's the answer. Because in a June 2011 chat between a UBS and Deutsche Bank trader comes down to the following: if you have stops, who are you gonna call? The stop buster. So it's funny, it's a big joke. That's UBS and Deutsche Bank saying, fuck you to your face, because they're gonna play the Ghostbusters theme song. Well, actually, it's kind of funny. I think you know I'm a musician. I actually did record the Ghostbusters theme song on one of my albums years ago. And I'm going to put this lyric in there so we can sing that to UBS and Deutsche Bank and show them how goddamn fucking funny that is to me. I think there's a couple more quotes here. Okay, I think we covered the main ones. And perhaps that is something that they could get the other banking executives to discuss with the president today. That's another thing that perhaps you can submit a tip, whistleblower alerts, protection, apply for an award. Again, I can understand that there are some people that are not easy position for whatever reason to do so. Although I encourage and applaud everyone that, whether you're sharing the information, submitting a claim, make it overwhelming, expose them. These banks are running, or they're doing crimes that depend on ripping people off. You heard them bragging about it. You heard the stop busters bragging about it here. Smash Brothers and the stop busters. You heard them bragging about it. You heard them saying, fuck you to your face. And I think it's disgusting. But the best part is that I was raised to do things right and be honest and moral. And we can do that. I would encourage everyone, please stay within the legal code. Don't do anything gray area. All you have to do is report factual information that where the executives of Deutsche Bank, I've never heard them comment on this. Where are the executives of HSBC? I've never heard them comment on this. Where are the executives of any of these people? Yet now there's even JP Morgan traders under investigation who are denying it. Yet we have confessions from to the CFTC, because these tough guys, they let the JP Morgan, they let the junior guys roast, who all, each and every single one, mentioned that it was widespread practice at the firm and done with the consent. It was taught to them by the supervisors. And these tough guys settle, never answer for it. And I believe the junior traders are getting roasted. So lastly, one favor I would need to ask folks, we are getting inundated with mail. I'm going through a ton of stuff. I appreciate greatly everyone that is trying to help. I would ask, unless it's really important that I see it right now, or something like that, there is the Wall Street Silver Group. These guys are doing incredible. They're taking the stuff, posting it. You can get a lot of those questions answered there. People on my Twitter feed, similar. So I would ask I'm doing everything I can and sharing everything as soon as I find it out. We'll be back in an hour and a half with Nick Barashev, who has done extensive research on SLV. Again, I'm just raising questions that, to me, as an analyst, I feel that I would be liable if I did not raise. So with that said, going to stop here for today. Hope this was helpful, and keep your eyes on what comes out of the meeting at the White House. Heard all sorts of fantastic things in the rumor mill. If there's anything I can confirm, I'll let you know. But as always, sure appreciate you being here. And from my perspective, it's exciting because this is no longer something that is in somebody else's hands. And I would encourage each and every one of you who's able to continue sharing this stuff and doing what you can to expose this, because I think they are on the ropes. And I think we can have an honest, moral, and legal impact in exposing that. So I will see you again soon.